In this tutorial, I'll be showing you the basics of creating a Wikipedia page using the edit source method. I'll be showing you how to create section headers, how to add content, how to link to internal Wikipedia pages, how to make sure that there is a table of contents, and how to reference outside sources. This is my sandbox page. Everyone who creates an account with Wikipedia is given a sandbox page. It does not return on any searches, making it the perfect environment to experiment and play and learn how to edit Wikipedia before changing any actual pages. The first paragraph on a Wikipedia page is typically a synopsis, some brief explanation of what the page should be about. I'm just going to type, "This is an example paragraph." This paragraph is meant to illustrate some point. So now if we go down to the bottom and hit Save Changes to display our results, we see we have the title of the page and then the example paragraph. We're going to now add another section. In order to add a section header, do equals equals and then type the name of the section header. I'm going to type in excerpt from Dracula, and then close it with equals equals to complete the section header. Now if we scroll down to the bottom and click Save Changes to see our changes, we notice that we have our example paragraph and our new section header. Going back to Edit Source, to give you an idea of how it will look when you populate it with content, anything below the section header in the markup will display as below the section header on the page. So I'm going to copy some text that I've lifted from the book Dracula in a notepad document here and paste it under here. So now if we hit Save Changes to show our changes, we have our example paragraph underneath the title, we have our example heading, excerpt from Dracula, and all of the content that was here. Now it's beginning to look more like a Wikipedia page. If we go back to Edit Source and create another section header, and another section header, and one final one. We've made four because after you make four example headers, or four headers, a table of contents will be automatically generated. So now we have the title of the page, the synopsis paragraph, our table of contents, and then content underneath headers. So going back here, suppose in one of these example headers, I wanted to make a reference to vampires. I might type in Dracula is a vampire. So if I want the text vampire to link to the actual Wikipedia page for vampires, I can use a link. To create this, do two opening square brackets and then type the exact name of the Wikipedia page. To make sure that I got the name correct, I've actually just opened the page for vampires on Wikipedia in another tab. I will copy the title and then paste it here. If I don't want the display text to be exactly the same as the title text, suppose I want to say that Dracula is a monster and have the word monster linked to the page for vampire. To separate the linking text and the display text, I will use a pipe. What's on the left of the pipe should be the exact name of the Wikipedia page, and what's on the right of the pipe can be whatever you want it to display as. So I will type in monster, and then close it with two square brackets. So now when I save my changes, I see here under my example header, it says Dracula is a monster, and monster is linked text. When I go open link a new tab, it brings me to the page for vampires. Going back to Edit Source, I'll show you how to reference outside sources. So suppose you got the information that Dracula is a monster from an outside source. In order to make a reference, down here at the bottom, there is this Cite Your Sources. Click this and it generates an open and closing reference tag. If you're familiar with HTML or other markup languages, you can simply type these yourself. The accepted format for making a reference is last name, comma, first name, parentheses, year, and then if there is a website, it will be in square brackets, and then finally the publisher, all within the two reference tags. Now, anytime that you make a reference, you want to make sure that there is a references section header. This will ensure that the references do not clutter up the area where the content is being displayed. They will simply display as a small superscript numeral, and the actual reference will go in the reference section associated with the numeral that is superscripted. It's easier to show you what I mean. I'll hit Save Changes, and you'll notice that we have our reference here. Right next to Monster, we have the small number 1, and underneath our References section, we have our last name, first name, year, website, and publisher. So that's it. That's the basics of creating a Wikipedia page using the Edit Source method. Happy editing!